In this edition of In Focus, see highlights from the annual shareholder meeting. Hear about a breakthrough for school children and the environment on Long Island. But first, some news. Keyspan's sphere of influence recently spread to the Middle East as Iraq's newly appointed Minister of Electricity, Dr. Iham Al-Samari, sought the advice of Keyspan's chairman and CEO, Bob Cattell. At the June 9th meeting in Hicksville, Cattell shared his insights with the minister on Iraq's challenging electric transmission and distribution needs, pending infrastructure projects, and the collection and transportation of natural gas. Besides his meeting with Cattell, Dr. Al-Samari was in New York to meet with representatives of the United Nations. For further information on this story, please see Keyspan online. Keyspan's emergency drill program was front and center at the Long Island, New York City Emergency Management Conference. It was held at the Hilton Hotel in Melville, where Bob Cattell presented Keyspan's emergency drill system, which is a model in the industry. And speaking of drills, LIPA Chairman Richie Kessel and Keyspan President Bob Fanny kicked off this year's blackout peak electric demand drill at the Rulin Road substation in Melville. Keyspan and LIPA employees participated in heat wave, blackout, and other emergency exercises. The successful drill refamiliarized employees with command and control procedures and helped identify areas for improvement. The island-wide drill made municipalities, business owners, and customers aware of the importance of being prepared for extreme weather and unexpected emergencies. There's cleaner air on Long Island thanks to the Long Beach School's decision to become the first district in New York State to operate an entire fleet of clean-burning natural gas school buses. The Long Beach School District received $1.2 million from the state's Clean Air School Bus Program, which will go to the purchase of 20 natural gas-powered school buses and retrofit the 18 existing diesel-fueled buses. And Keyspan designed and constructed a new CNG fueling station on Long Beach, which allows the school district to receive a $500,000 tax credit. Keyspan officials joined NYSERDA and the Long Island Clean Cities Coalition to kick off the program. In New England, Keyspan employees teamed up with the company's City Year environmental team to spruce up the crown jewel of Boston's Emerald Necklace Park system, Franklin Park. Led by Nick Stavropoulos, several teams of employee volunteers worked side by side with City Year Corps members. They all raked and swept up leaves and litter to get this beautiful open space ready for the 36th annual Kite and Flight Festival. Keyspan was title sponsor in collaboration with Mayor Menino, and it's an annual tradition. What better way to see the connection between Keyspan and the environment than to run across a clean green field with the wind at your heels and a Keyspan kite high in the sky? Keyspan volunteers also lent a helping hand to this year's Long Island two-day breast cancer walk, which was held in early June and began at Smith Point State Park. Over 15 Keyspan employees, family members, and friends staffed aid stations, handing out water and snacks to the walkers. They also cheered everyone during the two-day 35-mile journey. The walkers included Keyspan employee Kathy Long, who raised over $1,000. Tricia Faltings also walked and raised over $2,000 in honor of her stepmother, who battled breast cancer twice. Tricia says the walk is a piece of cake compared to the tough road her stepmom and other cancer survivors have traveled. The net proceeds raised by this event will be distributed to breast cancer organizations throughout Long Island. It was a meet and greet for Bob Cattell, the CEO, and Kenny Moore, the former Monk. The dynamic duo were the guest speakers at a Meet the Authors breakfast held at the Brooklyn Public Library. Bob and Kenny co-wrote the book, The CEO and the Monk, which was published earlier this year. They discussed their unique business relationship, their collaboration on the book, and finished the morning with a book signing. The setting was MetroTech, the date was May 20th, and the event, Keyspan's annual shareholder meeting. As chairman and CEO, Bob Cattell spoke to an audience full of Keyspan investors. He made it absolutely clear what Keyspan's focus is now and for the future.
Our focus is on pipes and wires and plants and people, on tangible strengths that provide the foundation for our core business a strategy, and an emphasis on shareholder value.
The chairman highlighted the success we've had in growing our core gas and electric businesses, monetizing our non-core assets, and improving our financial position.
We achieved a 7% growth in earnings, resulting in earnings of $2.64 per share. We maintained a solid A quality credit rating, and our stock appreciated 4.4%. When combined with a dividend yield of about 5%, that results in a total return to our shareholders of about 10%.
On the forefront of many investors' minds was Keyspan's $1.78 per share dividend, particularly when the company is going to raise it.
Over the years, I've continued to assure you that our dividend is secure, and I want to reinforce that again today. And as our balance sheet and cash flow keep improving, we will look to raise the dividend. But when we do that, we want to be sure that we can sustain it over the long term.
One of the keys to raising the dividend is controlling costs despite a higher cost environment. The chairman recognized Keyspan's achievement in this area.
Last year, for example, we cut costs by $100 million, maintaining our budget at 2002 levels, yet our customer satisfaction ratings were some of the highest ever.
Bob Cattell also called attention to the importance and value of adding natural gas infrastructure in the Northeast.
We want to bring natural gas to those who demand it. And we want to keep prices at a reasonable level and reduce price volatility. That's why we continue to work hard for the Islander East Pipeline to Long Island and the Millennium Pipeline to New York City, where we signed on as a major shipper.
In addition, the ongoing importance of LNG to the company and its customers through the upgrade of Keyspan's Providence, Rhode Island facility was stressed.
With Keyspan's record being the largest owner-operator of LNG storage in North America and our high standing as a corporate citizen, we think the future of our Providence venture bodes well for us and the entire Northeast.
Keyspan's electric business unit had another solid year despite the cooler than normal weather. Two highlights were the successful opening of the new Ravenswood unit and the company's response to the great blackout of 2003.
Our response to this unprecedented event was one of the greatest examples of ingenuity, cooperation, and hard work I've ever witnessed. It featured our most important asset, our employees, who showed their skill and pride in getting Long Island and New York City up and running in a little more than 24 hours.
The chairman also outlined his strategy for managing the energy services business, which had a year below expectations.
Since we believe that the service we provide through this segment offers value to our customers and supports Keyspan's other core businesses, we are reviewing every component of energy services and will make the necessary and appropriate changes to ensure its profitability.
Keyspan also continues to monetize its non-core assets, realizing $1 billion through their sale since 2001. The chairman explained his divestment strategy.
While our non-core assets have been very good investments, none of them are central to our strategy, and monetizing them to allow us to reinvest that cash and concentrate on our greatest strength and competency, our core operations.
As always, Bob Cattell made it a special point to thank employees for their excellent work and how they play a part in Keyspan's growth strategy.
They continually work with us to improve productivity and develop a high-performance, results-oriented organization. They will lead our growth.
In closing, the chairman thanked shareholders for their continuing trust in Keyspan.
My fellow shareholders, we will continue to work hard to enhance our reputation as one of the best energy companies in the industry. We take your commitment to us very seriously and will remain in focus every day to ensure that you earn the best possible return on your investment. Thank you very much.
That's it for this edition of In Focus. I'm Carmen Fields. We'll see you in September. Have a great summer.